I met Rich in 1989. I got a job in West Palm Beach at Channel 25, and we had a great staff, sports director Mark Goldberg and Barry Hochberg, and Rich was the sports photographer. And we quickly became great friends, and in fact, he was one of the greatest friends that I'll ever have in my life. This is the time. We hit it off right away. We, as it turned out, grew up 15 minutes away from each other on Long Island. We both loved the Mets. We argued about every other team. He loved the Islanders winning all those cups. I was a Ranger fan. He liked the Jets. I liked the Giants. We both went to school upstate and would argue about how great our communications program was. And I'll tell you this, nobody was more proud of their alma mater than Rich Tucker and Buffalo State. I had never even heard of the Buffalo State Bengals. This is the time to remember, 'cause it will not last forever. We covered some big events, and Rich won a lot of awards in his career. One I remember was covering Charlie Hustle, Pete Rose. He's doing a radio show in West Palm Beach. It's the day after he's eligible for the Hall of Fame. Nobody can interview him, but Rich came up with a good idea to get a good angle of Pete Rose.
Craig, you're on the air. Hello.
Hello, gentlemen. I'm actually here in the studio covering this day, and reinstatement has to happen for you, obviously.
Oh, I know that, and I haven't really chose to apply for reinstatement at this time.
Rich was a masterful shooter. Somehow I never got under his skin. He always wanted to get the extra shot. He always went the extra mile, like the 1990 NBA All-Star Game in Miami.
I think he'll come in second.
Hello, man. If I finish second, that's great.
Rich and I were big NHL fans. Anytime there was an excuse to cover hockey, even though we were in South Florida, we jumped at it. Like the time at the Breakers when the NHL was expanding, and it was either going to be Ottawa or perhaps Florida to get an NHL team.
Let's go, Ottawa! Even without presidential help, I think we've got a very good chance of getting a franchise.
And when Major League Baseball came back to South Florida, Rich and I got a great assignment from Channel 25 to do a special series, a week-long series called Play Ball.
Great to see you.
Thank you.
Congratulations.
I don't see how you can plead for a team, get a team with a lot of money, and then have any pessimism whatsoever.
Well, it's going to be a thrill for those who have kids. The Mets are coming to you, and they are going to get you guys.
If you ever make it to the World Series, you get goosebumps this big.
To be able to root for the nine guys on the field that do what your dreams are is the feeling that a fan has, and that's the feeling that they're going to have.
We also got a chance to cover the Super Bowl over in Tampa. It was Super Bowl 25 on Channel 25. And of course, Rich had to find a Buffalo story at a bar where the mayor was.
Go Bills! Go Bills! Yeah! Let's go! Let's go!
This is better than my honeymoon. I love it. It's a great crowd. What fans! That's why we're going to win.
Rich wasn't fast, but he was a hustler. When we used to cover the PGA Seniors Championship, golf was a tough thing to cover because in the early holes, NBC wouldn't be shooting it, and we'd have to go all over the course.
And he's sure making those putts, and it's unbelievable.
It's great to see anyone that can set a golf course on fire.
I looked at the leaderboard, and I saw Gary was 8-under after 10 holes, and I said, oh, my gosh.
Rich one day was right on with Lee Trevino. Trevino shot at the PGA Seniors Championship, a major, a 29 minus 7 on the front nine, and then he eagled the 10th hole. NBC didn't have any of the video, but Rich Tucker had it. And Rich sold the video to NBC Sports. I think we got $200 plus an NBC golf shirt.
He's fantastic. He's a great player. He's a great guy.
Rich got a lot of mileage out of the NBC Sports golf hat with a big giant palm tree on it. I think it was pink with the peacock. He wore it for more than a decade. But for all the big events we covered, Rich had as much passion for the smaller stories as anybody. And that's what really made him special.
I'm down here to play underwater hockey. And they said, what?
You told me not to worry.
Yeah. Oh, I dropped my glove.
Don't worry.
I dropped my ball.
Right away, the first hit of the afternoon, 17 years old. Julio Arellano.
The sad thing to see your record broken or a happy feeling?
Well, it was both happy and sad. I'm sort of like old Ty Cobb up there in heaven. When Pete Rose got close, I thought it'd be nice to be number two guy for a while.
Much of Rich's foundation probably came from his days as an Eagle Scout as a kid, and he had many letters from dignitaries honoring him. He always seemed to care more about others than even himself. He just didn't ski with his buddies and pay his yearly dues to the Gator Ski Club he belonged to. He took pictures and documented all of their trips, like their trip to China. Rich put together a tableside book of photos and memories from the extravaganza that looked like something you'd see at Barnes & Noble. He did videos for me that were simply amazing, like our wiffle ball games. We stopped by my elementary school while we were shooting in New York, and some buddies came out, and of course, Rich always got the great cutaway shots.
Well, I'm taking a Greyhound on the Hudson River line.
Please miss me.
I'm in a New York state of mind.
My family ski trip videos always had that Rich Tucker touch.
I'm leaving on a jet plane, don't know when I'll be back again.
And when my dad turned 90, Rich's 25-minute video had the Minervini family literally in tears. In 1994, Dan Marino fooled the Jets with the infamous spike play. He fooled Pete Carroll, who later won the Super Bowl. He fooled the entire defense. In fact, Jets defensive end Marvin Washington later said, "We basically fell for the old banana in the tailpipe trick." Well, he fooled all the Jets that day and ended up losing four games and firing the coach after that. But one guy he didn't fool, you got it, Rich Tucker. On his Facebook page, Rich writes, "I fall for no fakes. On my honor, I will do my best to do my duty to God and my country, and to obey the scout law to help other people at all times, to keep myself physically strong, mentally awake, and morally straight."
It's something unpredictable, but in the end it's right. I hope you had the time of your life. It's something unpredictable, but in the end it's right. I hope you had the time of your life.
Once a scout, always a scout. And I hope that you know how all of us love you so much. You're a great friend, Rich Tucker.